I want to thank all of you for listening today. We are here to remember, to care for the final resting places of our loved ones, and to place flowers on their graves. All of us have places in cemeteries that are special. Places we are attracted to that hold our memories as we seek to remember those we love. Although men and women in the American Armed Forces are fighting wars in Iraq and Afghanistan, and many thousands have been killed and wounded there, most Americans will spend Memorial Day without a thought of the sacrifices others have made. Memorial Day is a day of remembrance for fallen veterans of all the nation's wars. If we remember how Memorial Day was started, it may help us to remember that dead for whom it is named. Memorial Day celebrations have been held for more than 150 years. Several towns claim credit for having the first Memorial Day celebration. Waterloo, New York, has the title of the birthplace of Memorial Day, although Charleston, South Carolina seems to have had the earliest recorded celebration. According to historical records, on May 1st, 1865, African Americans in Charleston paraded to a cemetery where 200 Union soldiers had been laid to rest. Children led the way, placing flowers on the soldiers' graves and singing patriotic songs. 3 years later, in May 1868, General John Logan, commander of the Grand Army of the Republic, issued General Order No. 11, designating May 30th as Decoration Day. General Logan's orders call for laying wreaths and flowers on the graves of soldiers, sailors, and Marines who had died in the war. Let no vandalism or neglect or ravages of time testify to the present or to the coming generations that we have forgotten as a people the cost of a free and undivided republic, Logan wrote. Why do we remember our battle dead? It is not just to honor their gallantry, bravery, and patriotism. Mostly, we honor their sacrifice in the cause of freedom and that noble experiment that is the United States of America, so we can recommit ourselves to that cause. Let us observe Memorial Day this weekend in accordance with its original purpose, to remember in sorrow and gratitude the price that was paid and is still being paid for freedom.
Thank you. sound taps. We want to thank each of you for viewing our online celebration of our veterans who have served and sacrificed for this great nation. For the year 2020, you are our heroes. Thank you for your viewing of this service.